There's a little bit of an irony to this. All fun ideas start on a piece of paper. This one ended up remaining on paper.
That was really what part of our inspiration is to think about a microscope that could literally be a dollar or less.
People found that silly, primarily because, of course, I said, oh, the right way to manufacture microscopes is out of paper. And that by itself was laughable. That was the grant that I wrote to the NSF. I was finally surprised that we were supported to pursue this idea of what I call print and fold optical instruments. When I started my lab, I spent some time in Thailand, India, South Asia, and experiencing and seeing the lack of capabilities that existed for lab technicians across the globe. Once you don't have the tools, no matter how dedicated or passionate you are in engaging with patients, you really cannot provide the best care. I remember being in Uganda talking to a person who had been training malaria microscopists for the last 40 years of his life. And he explicitly told me, Manu, you should come back to me when you can do diagnosis under a tree. Jim was a graduate student at that time, and I met him by a coincidence because he was looking for a lab to work in. You know, I think his background showed that he cared deeply about people that I cared about, which is people that have very little.
When I met with Manu, we talked about, I think, three different ideas that he had. And the one that really, caught my attention was related to making a low-cost, you know, version of a microscope using a ball lens. The same day that I met him, he just invited me to come in the lab and, you know, just start playing around with different things to get started. You know, we just got some ball lenses. Your first thought of how to try to view something small through a ball lens is you just pick it up and you try to look. The first thing that goes wrong is that you end up poking yourself in the eye, right? Ultimately, where we made our big jump forward is when we found this source for black paper. It's a cardstock paper. The big step after that is really just to make the paper big enough so that it really gets your fingers out of the way of your eye. After that, it was just lots and lots of iterations and, you know, brainstorming about different features.
A lot of people have told me I'm crazy. I think I do remember explicitly a time we wrote a paper, we figured out that it worked. The next day, Bill Gates tweeted about it. It's like, oh, a $1 microscope, interesting, question mark. And it stuck with me. It's like, why did he add a question mark? Up till now, we had built 100 every time in batches, all done by hand. And then that day, the mission had changed. That tweet inspired me to flip that and said, we're going to make 10,000. And it turned out we overshot. We made 75,000 of them. And so then we chose another harder problem, which is we're going to make 100,000 of them. Then we made 1,000,000. And now at this very moment, we are actively thinking about how to manufacture 10 million of them. At this point, we have made more number of microscopes than many 200-year-old companies in this space, primarily because accessibility is at the heart of what we do. Everybody deserves the right to explore science, no matter what your background is. Most important work really has happened in the community, which remains independent from the commercial entity because the community is driven by the community of users. There was a guy in Seattle who heard about Foldscope and decided to quit what he was doing, and he biked from Laos to Cambodia to Thailand, all across, for the next year, running hundreds of Foldscope workshops. That's what he did. Everybody has an innate capacity to create knowledge.
When you share something with them that, you know, allows them to kind of see the same world they've always seen before, but in a new way, it can be very exciting.
True understanding of science comes from engaging in the process. And I very strongly feel we're just getting started. We truly have the capacity of bringing scientific literacy in a very physical way globally.